Are you facing similar issues in your school? Even after implementing a school management software? Don't worry. This is the right video that you have jumped into. I am Abhiraj and I am the co-founder of SchoolPad. As part of SchoolPad, I worked with over 200 schools and helped them implement a school management software. In this video series, I have tried to consolidate all my learnings in the last decade and create 5 crisp videos which will help you make the most out of your school management software. Make sure you watch all the 5 videos, because at the end of the 5th video, I can ensure 2 things for you. First, you will be able to figure out all the issues and understand the reasons behind it. 2, you will be able to extract most value out of your school management software. So are you ready? Let's get started. So this is video 1 of the 5 video series that we are doing to help you make the most out of your school management software. Now, we're keeping this video very basic, very fundamental. This video will talk about the first most important thing, which is selecting a school management software. Now, why do you think we took this topic? Because I've been visiting schools and I generally see that there is no defined, clear process by which schools can evaluate a school management software. And that is a big reason as to why they struggle a lot of times after the implementation happens. So I'll give you a 4-point process which will help you evaluate your school management software and select the best one for your school. So let's start with the first part. The first part is defining your triggers. What do you mean by defining your triggers? Let me explain this with an example. Let's say you have a school of 50 kids and this is year one. Year one means 50 kids and you would be easily be able to manage it on an Excel file. You as the owner or principal of the school would be able to check the progress by directly talking to people or checking the Excel file. But as your school grows, when you reach the third or the fourth year and let's say you have 400 kids, then keeping a track of the progress becomes really difficult. So that is the point when you will have this thought that you should implement a software to keep track of the progress and the growth of the school. Now, this is something which will stay back of your mind, but then eventually you might have these complaints coming in from parents. For example, a parent comes in and says, I need a better way to pay my fee. All schools are providing a payment method which is online payment, and in my school I don't have an online payment method. I have to go to a bank or come to the school and pay the fee. Or they might say that they are getting reminders again and again, whereas they have already paid their fee. So these are issues which will trouble you. And once you feel that these issues are getting over and over and they're coming up in big numbers, that will be the point when you will feel that now we need to implement a school management software. So what is a trigger area? This is basically a trigger area. This is the point which will push you to make a decision and which will actually force you to implement a software which will help you keep track of the progress and ensure that these inconsistencies don't happen. But the problem is you don't have to keep these trigger areas in your mind. You have to have a clear document which has all these trigger areas. Why? Because this document will help you evaluate your school management software. So that's the first point. Make sure you have a clear documentation of your trigger areas. In the same example, if we talk about the trigger areas, what would be the trigger area? So let's say point one, your first trigger area would be parents complaining about non-availability of a payment mode which is online payment mode. Two, parents getting messages of fee reminders whereas they have already paid their fee. So if you document this clearly, it will help you to evaluate your school management software better. If this is done well, this is the first point which will ensure that the entire process or the entire implementation process, selection process goes right for you. Let's move on to point two, defining your processes and systems. So you have defined the trigger areas. Now we have to see what are the processes and systems around these trigger areas. Now, what are processes and systems? You have been achieving something. So for example, in this case, the same example that we have taken, you were collecting fee. There was an accountant who was collecting fee. He was sending reminders, but still there were challenges which were coming in. So Since the process was already happening and you were doing the fee collections, you just have to make a document where you have to mention these steps of the processes which are already happening in the school. So in this example, the first process could be the fee collection person or the accountant makes entries into his Excel file and makes a note of all the fee collections that are happening in the school. In case the fee collection is happening by a check or the parent is going to the bank and depositing the fee, he goes to the bank, collects the receipts and makes the entries defining the mode, the amount, maybe the admission number, the date, everything, all the important details in an Excel file. So this is first step or the first point when you're defining the process of the trigger areas that we have figured out in step one. The second step could be on 10th of every month, because that is the due date, the accountant creates another Excel file from the existing data and sends a reminder to all the fee defaulters. So it is important that we have this entire process documented, because if we have the key trigger areas documented and then the next step we have the processes around these trigger areas defined on a piece of paper, then it becomes very easy to take this piece of paper and evaluate or test your system against these areas. See, you need to understand that implementing a school management software is basically helping you to optimize your existing processes or enhance your existing processes. So whatever you are doing, what is in place already, it has to be mapped to the software so that the software helps you enhance, optimize, and maybe automate those existing processes and help your school grow better. So let's move into point three. Now, point three is an easy step. You've already done the hard work by creating a nice document with your trigger areas and your processes around those trigger areas. In the third step, we're going to evaluate the software. So within your budget, you might have shortlisted certain softwares. Now is the point when you have to evaluate these with your trigger areas. So with that piece of paper, you can pass it on or share it to your software vendors and they will help you evaluate the software by mapping all those trigger areas, mapping all these processes and helping you figure out whether the software is capable enough to give you value or will help you achieve the issues that you are facing with your existing processes. So that is point three. Keep your document ready, share it with the vendor, evaluate the softwares that you have shortlisted using this document and see which one fits in best, which one works the best in helping you manage the entire journey. And why I say journey is because you don't have to evaluate the software looking at the outcomes. It is the journey that you have to use to evaluate the software, because that is what will make the entire process easy or difficult for the people who will be using the software. So let's look at the final point, which is point four. Now, this is one of the most important points, because till this point, you have actually selected and shortlisted one of your school management softwares, which according to you is the perfect fit for your school. So what next? Ideally, you will start the implementation and the software team will start working with you, supporting you, training you to help you implement the software. But this is not the point where we should start the implementation. A crucial point that most schools miss is defining roles and responsibilities. Now, at this point, just before starting the implementation, it is important for you to define who will be doing what. Since we are starting with the trigger areas, and that is the right way to start because that is what you need to achieve first, you need to define next to each step in your process who will be doing or working on that process and to what extent. Now, what I mean by that is, for example, you define that ABC is the name of the accountant who will be making the fee collections. But at the same time, you might not want ABC to give concession to the students. Maybe a person who is higher in the hierarchy as part of the accounts team, he is the one who is allowed to give concessions. Or maybe you want someone from the management who will be allowed to give concessions to the students. So this is what you need to define as the next step or the final step before you start the implementation. Who will be doing what and to what extent, so that this particular document can then be shared with the implementation team and they can map those roles along with their responsibilities or maybe the accessibility areas and help you implement the software from that point. See, you need to understand that your school management software is not a Facebook page or an email account which one or two people can handle. It is a software which is going to be used by all the departments across your school, and there will be so many people who will be using it. So to ensure that there is enough accountability in the system when so many people use it, it is really important to document who would be doing what and to what extent, so that people can be held accountable and eventually the entire implementation doesn't fail. So make sure you have this point in place. And I think if you have all these four points documented, it will not just help you evaluate your software, select the perfect one for your school, but even review it over and over. So hope you liked this video and found it useful. In case you found it useful, please make sure that you like and subscribe so that you don't miss out on the upcoming videos. Thanks for watching.